let me recognize Uwemudo, immediate past captain of Ikoyi Club. Incidentally, he's a member of the committee planning this tournament. Let me also recognize we call him the DG, Celestine Etuwem, Iswa Donchichi, the PR of the club. You're all welcome. You know, all other protocols and duty of them, you're all welcome. We decided to host this press conference to let the entire world know what is coming up from the 24th to the 26th of September. Incidentally, you know that the Kwaibun State is celebrating anniversary on the 23rd. So this week is a week of celebration. And so it is customary for the golf club to also be part and parcel of this celebration. So more or less, you know, this tournament is, while it is a golf tournament, it is also to be part and parcel to celebrate, you know, what how Ibom State came to be, the birth of Ibom State. And that is why we decided to christen it the Governor's Cup. I know maybe you might have questions about the name, the Governor's Cup, and we'll wait to answer that question or some other questions. But we're having a golf tournament here, and for some reasons that I know, you know, we started planning this thing 3 months ago, and we opened the portal for registration 3 months ago, and we wanted to close the portal this week, but 10 days after we opened the portal for registration, we were oversubscribed. We wanted the 150 players to be here for the tournament, but as we speak today, over 200 players had registered 10 days after opening the portal for registration. So we had to close it down because this facility has its capacity. In fact, for the numbers that we have now, we are trying to see how we will stretch this facility for the purpose of that accommodation. The simple reason is that this is the best golf course, not only in Nigeria, it is comparable to any golf course outside this country. That is why you see it has now turned to be like a golf pilgrimage, you know, for golfers, not just within the country, but outside the country. So anything that has to do with Ibom, you know, you'll find people coming, want to come in. As we speak today, we have line up of people waiting on the list. You know, but I don't think we'll be able to accommodate them. The technical people keep saying to me that, look, we can accommodate them. But we'll see what we can do. So that's why we want the press to be part and parcel of what we are doing. Because you can have good things, but if you don't publicize it, people don't know about it, it will just be hidden there. This is the best golf course in Nigeria, one of the best in Africa. It can stand any standard tournament. Mm-hmm. A little bit of trick, it can stand any standard tournament. The likes of Tiger Woods can come here and play. And that is what we are moving towards. So we have this tournament, and we have about 200 people that are coming. On Friday, the 24th, it will be the arrival. On that same Friday, we normally have what we call practice round. And after that, we have a welcome cocktail on that Friday. And then on Saturday is the tournament day one. Tournament day one and the kickoff of the tee-off, we call it the tee-off, which His Excellency the Governor would do. And then on Sunday is the tournament day two. And on that same Sunday, results will be out, and the results will be the first day tournament and the second day tournament, or the second day play. First day play and second day play will be added, and then the winner will emerge. But there are so many trophies. There are so many trophies and prizes. But the overall winner would always come out of that so many prizes and trophies. So the number of people that are coming are not just people. High net worth people. You have the likes former governors are going to be here. Even governors of some states are going to be here, you know, for this tournament. And we have the MD and the ED of Polaris Bank. They are going to be here because they are the ones that are the lead sponsors of this tournament. Ibom Air, you know, they are going to be here in their full force. And so many other people. So it's not just a game of golf. It's an opportunity to expose what we have as far as Accra State is concerned, and it's an opportunity for even investment in the future as far as Accra State is concerned. I used to say, when they said that there is investment potential as far as this area of golf is concerned, but I say it is investment reality. It has moved from potential now to reality. So ladies and gentlemen, we are set, we're ready, and then we'll be hosting over 200 high net worth individuals who are coming here to play golf, some with their families, some with their wives, to play golf. And we want the press to be part and parcel of it. We want people to know that this is a place to be. It's Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And on Monday, you know, they will disperse to their different destination. The hotel is fully booked, completely booked. In fact, today I was just talking to GM about just one room for the ED to give me, and they're trying to see how they can get a room out for the ED of Polaris Bank, you know. So, you see the complementary role this place is playing as far as the hotel is concerned, you know. So on from the 24th to the 26th, we're here and we'll be playing host to Nigeria, and the tournament is called the Governor's Cup, and it's not a one-off tournament. It's a tournament that is in series. Next year is going to come in 2023 is going to come, and 2024 is going to come, you know. So that's why we decided that the press has to know about this. So you're welcome, and may God bless Accra Ibom State.
Feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up when